Zippity-doo-dah, beautiful day, great to be alive. Hey, what's up everyone? This is Chris Brown here again. Now as I kind of spin around here, I'm hanging, as you can see behind me, I'm hanging out here at the boardwalk at the Yacht and Beach Club Resort here in Walt Disney World. And I'd like to officially welcome you to module number 2 of the Unfair Advantage Marketing System. And what we're gonna do in this module, we're gonna focus on your 80-20 rule. And this is where you're making 80% of your money, and that way you can focus on your most profitable tasks. So what we're gonna do now is I'm gonna take you to my computer so we can go ahead and get started. Hey everyone, this is Chris Brown here again, and I'd like to welcome you to module number 2 of the Unfair Advantage Marketing System. Now in this module, we're going to show you where you make 80% of your revenue so you can focus on your most profitable tasks. Now before we continue, what would that mean to you? No more sleepless nights, no more stress, no more anxiety, no more missing out on your kids growing up. Now let me ask you this. If you did not show up for work, how much would you make? If you have to work to get paid, that's a job. That's not a business. Now, even if you only make a penny per day, as long as your business earns it and not you, that's a business. Now, as you all know, most business owners are trapped into working 12 to 14 hours a day because they don't know the simple business principle that separates successful business owners from those that are struggling. Now, as you all know from firsthand experience, small business owners are some of the hardest workers out there because most small business owners pretty much do everything, right? They are the labor, they are the customer service, they are the administrative staff, they are the cleanup crews. Again, they pretty much do everything, right? So because of this, you should run your business off the same principles that big businesses do. Now, in business, there's a thing called as a USP, stands for a unique selling proposition. In other words, what makes you different? What makes you stand out from your competitors? Now, as you look around in the marketplace of today, it's filled with a lot of clone businesses. You know, everyone is pretty much doing the same thing, offering the same type of products, the same messages. It just might be under a different company or a different brand name. And so people have gotten numb to the way that you do business. Now, in 1997, Apple ran a commercial not to get more customers, but to let people know what it is that they stand for. Want to see it? It's called The Crazy Ones. Just click on the image of Steve Jobs. So, as you see, the only way to succeed in today's new economy is to use out-of-the-box thinking, or as Steve Jobs calls it, think differently. Now, what I'm about to show you is not for everyone. If you're sick of the same old mediocre business strategies that only get you the same old mediocre results, then this is for you. Now, in module number 1, we showed you that in business, you use quantum physics, whether you're aware of it or not. In today's new economy, you have to be smarter than your competition, or else you will lose your customers to them. You may not understand quantum physics, however, you can use some of the basic principles of it. Now, in our last module, we talked about the 80-20 principle. You get 80% of your results from 20% of your efforts. This is why so many of you are working way harder than you need to. Now, let me ask you this. Are you in the top 20% of your industry? If not, you only have access to 20% of the money spent in your industry, in which you are sharing that with 80% of your competitors. Do you like letting your competitors steal the money from your family? If you have been in business for 10 years or more, are you making more or less money than you were 10 years ago? Now, research from Sony shows that the average business is spending 6 times more in advertising to get the same results they got 10 to 15 years ago. Here's why. In 1992, the average person was exposed to 3,000 marketing messages per day. Today, the number is over 30,000 marketing messages per day. In this new economy, the way people buy is different, so the way we have to sell is different. And since almost everyone's sales message looks the same, because people have gotten numb to the way most businesses market themselves. So unless you're willing to spend 6 times more in advertising, the only way to get ahead is to use out-of-the-box thinking. So what does this mean? So for every $100 spent at your business, if you're not in that top 20%, this means that you are losing 80% of the revenue you could be making, and so thus you're only left with $20. Now you share that $20 with 80% of your competitors. And so out of that, that leaves you only left over with $4. Now let's say that you only make $4,000 per month. Let's keep it moderate. Yeah, I know a lot of you make a lot more than that. I know some of you might make even less than that, but let's keep this a moderate estimation, okay? That means if you make $4,000 per month, that means that you are cheating your family out of $100,000 per month and cheating them out of your valuable time, deciding to work the 10 to 14 hours a day when you could only be working 2 hours a day and spend more time with them. Now, like I said before, most small businesses don't know this stuff. This is what the big companies pay the big bucks for me to share with them. When you use what is called as a funded proposal. Now, a funded proposal is what earns you 80% of your money in only about 90 minutes to about 2 hours for most businesses. Sometimes it might take a little bit more, but on average, it's about 90 minutes to about 2 hours. Now, McDonald's is a funded proposal business. Now, I'm gonna ask you a very obvious question, but keep in mind this is a trick question. Now, what does McDonald's do? Now, of course, what most everybody is gonna say is they sell fast food. Absolutely, you know, they sell hamburgers, the Big Macs, French fries, those famous apple pies. That is their business, but it's only a portion of their business, not the entire business. So let's look at, before we go on, let's look at McDonald's business model, okay? So again, McDonald's sells fast food, which obviously generates an income for them, right? And then that also generates a whole bunch of leads for them. Because if you remember, maybe in the 70s, I think they probably did it in the 70s too. I was too young to actually know this, but I do know for sure in the 80s and then the 90s, they had like 77 billion served worldwide, 88 billion served worldwide, 99 billion served worldwide, and they would put that on the big golden arches in front of every McDonald's, right? So this business model also generates them a whole bunch of leads. They funnel those leads into a system, and then a few business-minded individuals end up buying a McDonald's franchise from them, right? And at $1.9 million a piece, this is what generates the vast majority of their income for them. Now, a confusion for many small businesses is how can McDonald's afford to run an advertisement where they're losing money? So in many small town communities or many neighborhoods, McDonald's might run a billboard that's costing them thousands upon thousands of dollars, and they're only selling a 99 cent product. So they're actually losing money on that advertisement. They don't have a nice return on investment. But the reason that they can do that is because they're generating so much money from selling the franchises that they can afford to do other types of advertising because they don't actually even care if they make money. They're actually losing money on that. They call that, in the business world, you may have heard of the term as a loss leader. So they're selling something where they're gonna actually even lose money on that, but it does generate a lead for them, and then they can put them into their system, and then they can sell them something more expensive, which is where they're gonna make all of their profits, right? So this is how McDonald's runs their business. And a lot of times, even if you're not a fast food restaurant, you might be trying to duplicate what McDonald's is doing. And this is why you haven't been able to duplicate it, because you don't really know what McDonald's business model is. Now that you know this, now it's gonna help you to achieve greater success. Now, according to Ray Kroc, who is the founder of McDonald's, in an interview featured in a famous business magazine many years ago, he explains it this way. He says that McDonald's was losing money at one time. Ray Kroc mortgaged almost everything just to keep things going. It was a big, huge money pit. He mortgaged his home, sold his investments. You know, he just pretty much mortgaged everything. He was going broke. It was a dying, dying business. That was until a friend made a suggestion that turned the entire business around. Okay, so what McDonald's now does because of this is McDonald's sells fast food, but they also sell franchises, which at $1.9 million a piece, at least at today's modern prices, is where they make 80% of their revenue, even though it's only a small percentage of their customer base. Now, let me ask you a question. Do you know things that new or already existing businesses don't know? If you do, this is how you can leverage the 80-20 principle and charge premium prices. Now, Bob Iger, the current CEO of Disney, recently said that Disney earns 80% of their revenue from 20% of their customers. Now, Disney has a high-end business coaching program called the Disney Institute. Julie Broughton, the Miss America winner of 2011, used this 80-20 formula to finance her modeling career. Now, how does real businesses use this? You know, the businesses in your local neighborhood. This is Ben Glass, who is a very successful lawyer. He teaches other lawyers how to be more successful in their business. Dr. David Peach, who is a chiropractor, has two chiropractic offices and helps other business owners to become more successful. He used this to finance two offices and make more than $1 million from this formula. So he can keep 100% of every dime he makes from his chiropractic business as profit. Now, all these businesses use a funded proposal income to finance their business, which is about 80% of their revenue with only 20% of their effort. Now, let me ask you this. Now, how much gold did the first millionaire during the San Francisco gold rush find? The answer, zero. He made $1 million selling the picks, the pans, the shovels, and all the tools the gold prospectors needed. Now, in today's modern business world, do you know businesses that need blogs, landing pages, mobile marketing, and all these things that today's modern business owner needs? Now, to some of you, this may seem like a strange idea because it's something most small businesses don't know about, but the exceptional ones do. And because it is new to some of you will resist it, partly because who you see yourself to be. Now, let me ask you a question. What do you do? Now, so many of you see yourselves as doing your craft. Many of you need to cut back on working because that's what you did when you had a job. You are now a business owner and you need to start selling. Because unless someone sells something, you won't have anyone to do your craft for. All customers are not created equal. I earn as much from one client as I do from 8,000 of my other customers, all because of this 80-20 principle. Many of you have been struggling because of this new economy. Now, one of my favorite actors, Will Smith, he's played in Men in Black, The Pursuit of Happiness, just a lot of Hollywood hit movies. He has one of my favorite sayings, one of my favorite quotes. He said this a few years back at the Nickelodeon's Kids' Choice Awards. He said, and I quote, "There have been millions and billions and billions and gazillions of people who have lived before us, and there is no new problem that you can have that someone has not written down the solution in a book." Now, many of you have been struggling because of this new economy. However, no matter how bad you think you have it, it is nothing as compared to the Great Depression. People were jumping out of skyscrapers and eating out of trash cans. Now, in our last module, I shared with you W. Clement Stone, how he made 122 sales per day, earning him over $1 million a year during the Great Depression. So his friends came to him and asked him what he did not only to maintain his wealth, but to prosper during this hard economic time. Now, in module number one, we revealed how W. Clement Stone used quantum physics to make those sales with what we call as the mathematical formula to writing your own check. Now, fast forward 80 years to the 2009 Great Recession. This is Mark Yarnell. He used the mathematical formula that W. Clement Stone used and expounded upon it. And just like W. Clement Stone friends, Mark Yarnell's friends asked him what he did not only to maintain his wealth, but what he did to prosper during this hard economic time. Now, Mark Yarnell is a self-employed businessman, built a $350,000 per month income in his first 12 months by using the 2-hour workday formula that you'll find down below directly underneath this video. Now, he also used to write for Success Magazine, which you can find in any bookstore. He also helped thousands of businesses to use the 80-20 formula to make $100,000 per month. Now, I can arrange a private consultation with him if you'd like. This is not hype. This isn't too good to be true. This isn't hype again once you know the science behind it. Now, in the book, The 4-Hour Workweek, it says, the best business is the one that takes the least time. This is how Mark Arnell explains it. We all have friends, family, hobbies, and things we'd rather do than working, right? However, we need the money and the time to do those things. How many of you just hate selling? Maybe it's not your most favorite thing, maybe you don't hate it, but maybe it's not your most favorite thing to do in the world. If you don't, how'd you like to make so many sales from word of mouth advertising that you'll never have to sell ever again? Before I show you this formula, let's look at one more business principle from McDonald's. Now, Ray Kroc was a brilliant business mind. He built a network of business owners who all sell the exact same product. Now, as you know, McDonald's on their signs sold 99 billion served worldwide. Did he sell all of his products? No. He built a network of business owners who all sell the exact same products. And they paid him $1.9 million for the privilege to be able to do that. I have a client who used this mathematical formula. And even though he was using this mathematical formula, he was still in a rut because he does not have enough time in his day to make more sales. He was able to make more profit per sale because by using the tools we provide as part of this system, but he was stuck in a rut. That was until he started using this formula that I'm about ready to show with you. For him, this also changed the entire direction of his business. So again, do you know things that new or already existing business owners don't know? Now, if you do, this is where you can charge premium prices and capitalize on that 80-20 principle. A business's biggest investment is marketing and people. You know businesses that need blogs, landing pages, email marketing, social media campaigns, and all these tools that today's modern business owner needs. And just like Ray Kroc, we have a network of business owners that allows you to capitalize on this 80-20 principle. Okay, so in order to get access to the expounded version of the mathematical formula to writing your own check, just click on the little link that you see in front of you, the orange little banner there, and you're gonna get instant access to this. So in module number one, we talked about the mathematical formula to writing your own check, which is for personal sales, and this one is for building a network. Okay, so here's the basic rules of this. Once you make 100 sales or add 100 people to your network, according to quantum physics proves this, but this is also the statement from Mark Arnell, that absolutely worst case scenario, you will make $100,000 per month. Now, at first that might sound like a lot of hype, it's unbelievable, but when you look at the science to it, then you can see why we can say something like that. Okay, so in order to get access to that, just go ahead and click on the little click here link that you see in front of you. Try to make sure that you're at a computer. It doesn't always work if you're on like an iPad or something like that. So try to make sure that you're sitting at your computer and just go ahead and click on the link that you see in front of you.